Now let me solve problem number 1.26 for you. Problem number 1.26. The problem is statement. Let's read it carefully. Point moves in xy plane according to this law. To the law x is equal to a sine omega t. And y is equal to a into 1 minus cos omega t. Where a and omega are positive constant. Find distance s traversed by the point during time tau, angle between point velocity and acceleration vector. Now this is an interesting problem. X varies according to sine function, means x constantly increases decreases. Y also varies according to cos function, means y also constantly increases decreases. And they had asked for distance traversed by the point during the first tau seconds. Ab saath mein unne velocity vector, acceleration vector ke beech mein angle pucha hai kisi bhi samay. First of all, what I'll do is I'll differentiate x dx by dt. Dx by dt is a sin omega t ka cos omega t into omega. And this dx by dt is velocity component along x axis. I'll differentiate y dy by dt. The velocity component along y axis, a minus a cos omega t, is a is a constant, it's 0, a into minus cos omega t ka hoega, sin omega t or omega t ka omega, this is velocity component along y axis. Now what I'll get is, from here I can get dx, this differential displacement during differential time is a omega cos omega t dt, and dy is a omega sin omega t dt. Now, this is differential displacement along x-axis during differential time. This is differential displacement along y-axis during differential time. So, I will get ds square is equal to dx square plus dy square. Here, ds is distance traveled during dt time. Ds is distance traveled during dt time. Dx square plus dy square jo hum karenge. So this ds square is equal to a square omega square into cos square omega t plus sin square omega t into dt square. So this ds square, ds square is a square omega square into dt whole square, or ds is equal to a omega dt. And in order to get the distance traveled, I'll simply integrate it at zero time, distance is zero, at tau time, distance is s. So, the distance traveled is a omega into tau. This is answer to part A. Then, what that asks us? Velocity and acceleration vector of point at as a function of time. Now, let me write velocity vector. Velocity vector would be vx into i cap plus Vy into j cap. So velocity vector would be written as, I hope main idhar likhta hu zyada acha rahega, velocity vector would be written as a omega into cos omega t into I cap plus a omega into sin omega t into j cap. This is the velocity vector. What is acceleration? Acceleration is dv by dt. I'll differentiate this and I'll say acceleration is cos ka differential hoega minus sin. So minus sin omega t minus a omega square sin omega t I cap or sin ka hoega cos. So a omega square cos omega t j cap. Now in order to get angle between them, what I will do is a dot v is mod a mod v cos of angle between them. Aap idhar se dekhiye mod v, mod v main pehle se hi likh deta hu, this cos this sin, vx whole square plus vy whole square and under root of it, mod v is a omega and mod of a is this sin this cos a omega square, this is mod of a. Now v dot a, I am applying this concept, or a dot v, I dot I, I dot I is 1, j dot j is 1, I dot j 0, j dot I 0. So a dot v is a omega minus a omega square into sine of omega t cos of omega t minus, and here plus, a omega into a omega square sin omega t into cos of omega t. This is equal to mod v is a omega mod of a is a omega square into cos of angle between them. Observe that this term and this term get completely cancelled. Ye to pura cancel ho raha hai. And we conclude that cos theta is equal to 0 means theta is pi by 2. This is answer to part B. The angle between velocity vector and acceleration vector is 90 degree, they are always perpendicular to each other. The cos theta value is 0. Please check the solution.